Content warning. Statutory rape, suicide, body dysmorphia, domestic abuse. Sable Hay Shields, aka Sable Starr, lost her virginity in 1970 at the age of just 12 to the musician Brandy California from the band Spirit. At 14, she began to frequent the Sunset Strip along with her friends, the Baby Groupies. These deeply insecure young girls were taken advantage of by many icons of the era, including David Bowie, Iggy Pop, Keith Richards, Jimmy Page, Johnny Thunders, and more. What follows here is an account of those years, told through real interviews with those who were there at the time. Look Away, the story of Sable Starr.
To do anything, look away. Look away.
The voice of Sable Starr, Baby Groupie.
I didn't really live in Hollywood. I was about 45 minutes away. But my friends called me up one day and said, "Do you want to go to the Whiskey a Go-Go?" This was when I was 14. I was still ugly then. I didn't get my nose fixed until I was 15. Oh, I hated school when I was 15. I had to have a probation officer. That's when I started living with Iggy Pop in the Hollywood Hills. I didn't go to school for about a month. I had to work on it for about a year when I was hanging out in Hollywood. You can't just walk away from anyone because you never know what they could do for you. Even if the guy is 120 years old, you have to be kissy with them because he might make good connections for you. I was very good at that.
The voice of Laurie Maddox, Baby Groupie, model. An underage ex-girlfriend of Jimmy Page.
What I remember most about the club was Bowie. I met him when he was doing the Spiders for Mars tour. David wanted to take me to dinner. Obviously, I had no homework that night. I had not yet turned 15, and he wanted to take me to his hotel room. I was still a virgin and terrified. I remember him looking like a god and having me over a table. Who wouldn't want to lose their virginity to David Bowie?
Sable Starr.
David Bowie came into town and wanted to meet me. So it wasn't a thing where I had to go running after him. At the hotel, I had to go to the bathroom, and David came in, and he had a cigarette in his hand and a glass of wine. And he started kissing me, and I couldn't believe it was happening to me, because there had been Roxy Music and Jay Giles. David Bowie was the first heavy. So we went to the bedroom and fucked for hours. I became very famous and popular after that, because I'd been accepted by a real rock star. Being a groupie doesn't pay. It's more of an ego thing.
Laurie Maddox.
Sable Starr lived to fuck rock stars.
The voice of Lee Blackchildus, photographer.
Well, Sable was on a general rampage of buying Billboard magazine and working her way down the list to find someone she hadn't fucked yet. Jane County came to stay with us at the house when she was still identifying as a gay man, and Sable came on to Jane very heavy. Jane said, "But I'm a fag." And Sable, well, her thinking was probably, "But you're next on the list." So Sable took off all her clothes, cut her wrists, and dove into the pool. She was floating face down in the deep end with blood going everywhere. And I was saying, "Jane, we have to get her out of there." And Jane said, "Why not let her drown? Let's take her over the cliff and pitch her off. Nobody will know where she came from."
The voice of Ron Ashton, member of the Stooges.
One day I was at practice and Lee Childers called up and said, "You gotta come back to the house. Sable's locked herself in your room and she's threatening to kill herself." I thought, what the fuck? It wasn't like we were in love or anything. It was just nice to get my dick sucked when I woke up. Sable had locked herself in the bathroom and I had to coax her out. "Come on, open the door." She finally opened it and she was just downed out. She was naked except for a bikini underwear, and she'd taken my razor and tried to slit her wrists. I just started laughing.
The voice of Queenie Glam, Baby Groupie.
I think the dream that's always inside, in the back of your mind, is to have a really famous guy fall in love with you and take you all over the world with him. Like, to marry him. Some girls are just out to marry a superstar.
Sable Starr.
The New York Dolls pulls up in this limousine, and Johnny Thunders was the first to get out of the car. He had this red leather suit on, the one on the back of the first album cover. And I just knew something would happen with Johnny. And it did. He asked me to stay the night, and the next day, he started laying all this heavy stuff on me. I really like you. I mean, I really care about you. I mean, really, like, I love you. Will you marry me? Will you come back to New York and live with me? I just turned 16. It was summer, and my mother was starting to make me register for school, so I ran away. I lived with Johnny in New York, but it didn't work out. Johnny and I were going to get married. We were going to have a baby, too. I did get pregnant, but had an abortion. Johnny tried to destroy my personality. He wanted me to sit there and be quiet and tell him I loved him 24 hours a day. After I was with him, I wasn't Sable Starr anymore. He had me throw all my diaries and all my phone numbers down the incinerator and ripped up my scrapbook. It was a good one, too. It had everything in it. After that, I was kind of just destroyed. That's why I felt so bad to have been such hot shit and to be let down to such a low level.
The voice of Serinda Fox, actress and model.
Johnny hit girls he was involved with. The first time I actually met Sable was after one of her fights with Johnny. The whole area under her lip was cut. She was beaten up. She was dirty. And her clothes weren't cute like I'm sure they were when she met him. I said to her, "What are you doing? Just go home."
Sable Starr.
After Johnny tried to kill me 4 or 5 times, I thought I'd take a trip back home. I was really fucked up over Johnny Thunders. Took me a long time to get it together.
Lori Maddox.
I never thought there was anything wrong with it, but maybe there was. I wouldn't want this for anyone's daughter. My perspective is changing as I get older and more cynical. I met up with Jimmy Page recently, and he said to me, "Lori, we were both children back then." I felt like saying to him, at least one of us was.
Sable Starr eventually got clean and sober. She got out of Hollywood and moved to Nevada, where she found a steady job and loving partner with whom she had 2 children. She died of brain cancer at just 51 years old. Look away. Sable Starr, Lissa Marie. Lori Maddox, Cara Adams. Ron Ashton, Joshua Wright. Lee Childers, Kit King. Serinda Fox, Shannon Pickrell. Queenie Glam, Shannon Pickrell. For Sable. A black and white photo of Sable Starr posing with her arms above her head, which is tilted to the side. She is wearing a low-cut jumpsuit and open velvet trousers.